Speak. Through time and space hast thou journeyed unto me, as I knew thou wouldst. We are the word of the Mother. We, who were once called Minfilia. Much time hath passed for thee since the bloody banquet, since I hearkened to her word. Mother, Hydaelyn guided me towards Ishtola and Thancred, that I might be swept up in their flow and delivered under the ethereal sea. There, adrift and alone, her voice silent once more, I prayed for those we had lost, for those we can yet save. To her I would make an offering. We speak now with one voice, one will. One word. Unto thee we bequeath the most precious of gifts, the truth which lieth at the heart of this world. Thus do we beseech thee once more. Hear, feel, think. Before there was life in the depths of the ethereal sea, light and dark did once dwell as one. But the darkness coveted power, and the balance was broken. Thus was I forced to banish him unto the distant heavens, to forever remain apart. A moon bound. In sundering the star did we cry out, and the barriers twixt planes chanced to falter. Across 10 and 3 were we then divided, reflections of the source, each possessed of a shard. Zodiac longeth to be made whole. For his restoration, for his resurrection, his servants labor without cease. They seek to tear down the barriers which surround the source. Thus do they rejoice in their ardor, in your calamities, for each marks a rejoining. Seven times have they succeeded. Seven times hath the darkness grown stronger. Seven times have I failed. The Asians cannot be suffered to continue. This is my final. The crystal's power is all but spent. With what remains, I will return you to the shore of the ethereal sea. Blessed children, go forth and seek. Seek.
Thank the 12!
Did you find her? Did you find Minfilia?
The word of the mother? I'm not sure I understand.
Nor am I. Cryer?
As unbelievable as it sounds, I see no reason to doubt her.
The word's tale. No one was more sensitive to the will of Hydaelyn than Minfilia. And if Hydaelyn has grown so weak that she can barely make herself heard, it is not hard to see why Minfilia, having joined with her, might struggle to maintain her own form.
What? Why would she need to maintain her own form? Are you saying she's gone? But that cannot be! Not now. Not after all we have accomplished. We were meant to usher in the dawn's light together.
She threw herself on the fire to fuel your dawn's light, boy. You'll just have to usher it in on your own.
Must you be so ungentle?
Tell me about the Scions, boy.
The Scions of the Seventh Dawn lay before Eorzea's salvation. Whenever the realm is threatened, be it by Primal, Ascian, Garlean, or any other, we take up arms in her defense, that all in Eorzea may live to see a brighter tomorrow.
And that's very noble of you. But in chasing after these lofty goals of yours, you seem to have lost sight of some basic truths. To win a war, you must be willing to do whatever it takes. To fight, to kill, and if necessary, to die. The path you've chosen is paved with the dead. Walk it with your eyes open, or not at all.
I know the truth of which you speak, and have from the first. If the Ascians will go to any length to resurrect their god, then we must needs be as committed to our cause, to unmask them and their schemes, and to crush them both utterly. Come, there is much to be done.
Yes, of course.
Thancred, wait! No. No, this is all wrong.
Pleasure to see you again, my friend. I take it you received our invitation. Good, good. You of all people should be present. When the true brothers of the faith seized control of the vault, I feared the worst. Yet in adversity were we blessed with the promise of peace between man and dragon through Vidofnir's timely rescue of an innocent child. Timely, I say, though miraculous or providential might better describe the event. The gods themselves could not have devised a more fitting symbol of hope. Needless to say, we could scarce let such an opportunity pass us by. Which is why I set about making formal arrangements for a peace conference between our peoples. You and yours have done more to bring us together than any, and it is only right that you attend. But I confess that is not the only reason I would be glad to have you there. Given Nidhogg's implacable opposition to the peace, it is possible that he and his followers may attempt to disrupt proceedings, in which event, your presence would be a comfort to all in attendance. Pray understand, I have no wish to invite the Worm's Ire, but if our fractured nation is to heal, if we are to move forward as a people united, then we must do whatever is necessary to bring about lasting change. Tis nothing. Lucia cautioned me against giving vent to my passions, lest my wounds reopen. It has not been easy reaching out to our opponents in Ishgard, many of whom sympathized with the actions of the True Brothers. But in so doing, we have limited the influence of the Zealots.
The people are ready, my friend. This conference must go ahead.
I knew you'd understand. The conference will take place on the border of Ishgardian and Dravanian territory in Falcon's Nest. Lucia is there, seeing to the final preparations, even as we speak. Pray join her at your earliest convenience. 'Twould not do for the guest of honor to arrive late, after all. Oh, and one more thing. A drink! We should make time for one. Once the conference is concluded, I mean. By my reckoning, 'tis long overdue.